Secretary, thank you for joining us again here on New Mexico in Focus.
Thank you, Russell. It's wonderful to be here.
You have dedicated your life to early childhood education. You now find yourself in New Mexico as secretary of a new department. What keeps you up at night as you tackle issues around early childhood education?
You know, Russell, I think that's a great question. I think I want to just make sure that we are able to really capitalize on all the wonderful things that are happening here in New Mexico and building on the incredible work that's happened here over the last two decades. I think nothing really keeps me up except that, you know, I'm impatient, so I want to see things, you know, move rapidly. But I see it. I mean, over this pandemic, this public health emergency, the outpouring of community and support and connection has been really overwhelming and has really helped us manage through this. So I feel so hopeful about the work ahead that nothing really keeps me up, but just that sense of excitement of what we can actually accomplish for families and young children.
Like many New Mexicans, I have a young toddler. She's 3 years old. Oh. If we're going to enter a good program for someone of her age, in an early childhood education setting, what would an ideal program look like for her?
Yeah, I mean, you're gonna see a rich relationship. So the teachers and you are gonna have an incredible relationship. They're gonna really respect you and wanna understand what your hopes and goals and dreams are for your daughter. She's gonna have lots of opportunity to explore and on her own interest, but really it's gonna be about strong relationships. The teacher's gonna know her, going to know where she's at developmentally, emotionally, and she's going to help her continue to grow from where she is in very intentional ways, but also through creating environments where she can explore on her own. I mean, children, as you know, every day you must just be amazed at what she is able to learn and do. And so rich with language, rich with experiences, those would be the kind of things we'd want to see in a quality early childhood setting and environment.
In a good department that is fully funded and has the support, what would it look like for somebody who is interested in this field to join it, to be in an ideal setting to make it a career? What is your vision for someone who is thinking about as a UNM student or New Mexico State student, thinking about jumping into early education as a career? Yeah. Why should they jump in this field?
Oh, because they can be part of a community, an incredible community of learners, and also to just be there to, I just actually was at the UNM Children's Campus. I stopped by there and got to finally see and hear the work they do of bringing young students in and how they get excited when they learn about what their role is as a teacher in shaping a young person's future educational and health and all their outcomes. So I think people, we want them to come, we want them to be excited about early childhood care and education and to really be change makers. You're gonna be supporting families at their most vulnerable time. Families are, you know, especially right now through the pandemic and the public health, they're wondering, should I take my child to care, shouldn't I? And here are these incredible young professionals giving them the assurance, respecting them as parents, appreciating their values and what they're bringing into the field. And so I think it's a place where you'll be supported. You'll always be learning. You'll always be growing and you will be transforming in children's lives and supporting families in very important and critical ways.
And how will you be measuring yourself in terms of accountability?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is a great question. I think we want to be very transparent. We want to make sure that the community knows exactly what we're doing and how we're prioritizing the budget that we have, how we're prioritizing our communication. And so we'll be, and also looking at our own staff in the department. You know, are they staying? Are they feeling well supported? Do they feel connected to our mission and part of a larger team and a larger purpose? Of course, the legislature was a very important stakeholder and the governor will be the ultimate decider but we hope that what we're doing to create this department is going to really be something that we all do together. And of course, I have a key signature role as the secretary in making that happen, but it is going to be all together New Mexico in making the early childhood education and care department a huge success.
Secretary, thank you for joining us for this extra special on New Mexico in Focus. We really appreciate it.
Thank you, Russell. It's been a pleasure.